Welcome. My name is Kia, and this is the second part of my little mini series of me taking care of Gotland wool. I did a little film here when I was preparing my wool and also doing some carding. And in this video, I will show you how I have spun this wool. And yes, you will come along with me during the process. And afterwards, I will talk to you a little bit about this finished product here. It's not really dry yet, but first I want to take you with me so you can see the spinning process. I am now spinning my Gotland fiber, my Gotland wool, and in a previous clip here you have seen me when I was preparing the wool for spinning, and I am trying to spin this as single, so I am spinning it long draw, and I am not putting in a lot of twist when I am spinning. I am just letting the twist go up a little bit in the fiber, just to take some more fiber with it out. And I also want it to be a bit fluffy, so I'm trying, when a lock comes and it's not perfectly lined up, I just let it pass because I want to have a fluffy single, and also if it's a little bit unevenly spun, that will be beautiful as well. So as you can see here, I am holding my yarn there, and then I let the twist go up and I'm pulling out, holding it and letting the twist go up and collect some more fibers. So that's how I am doing this long draw spinning. And I really hope that this will be nice. I did the first skein that I showed in a previous podcast here. I was just feeling a little bit you know, testing out, trying the fibers, trying to feel the fiber and the also the wheel, and getting used to the fiber and how I wanted to spin it, because I have been spinning a lot of short forward. So now when I am spinning long draw, I had some learning to do just to get the hands back into spinning this long draw again. I'm hoping that this will be a nice single yarn of Gotland, and also looking forward to knit something from it. But I have been spinning a lot of beautiful yarns lately, and when I finish them, I'm not sure what to knit with them, but I'm so longing to create something with it. But I'm also longing for the next spin, so being a bit torn apart here with what to put my time to. But long draw, or this way of spinning, is quite quickly, because I just I'm just creating a single, so I'm not, I don't have to ply or anything. So when I'm done with my spinning, I can show you here. Hello. the first skein that I did, I have washed and skeined up like this. And the pink that you see is just yarn that I used to hold it together. So the first skein of my Gotland is done. And this was the testing skein, I must say. And yesterday I got so excited, and I just sat down and filled a whole bobbin. I got so in the flow with how to spin this. So I spun up a whole bobbin. And now I have got half of this bobbin filled, and this is what I have left of the wool. So I think one more bobbin and then I'm done. And I'm so excited to do the measurements. How many meters will I get from this? So yes, doing the spinning now is so enjoyable. And I have a audio book going, and I'm spinning and I'm listening to the book, and it's so nice. So what am I spinning on this time? I will flip the camera. So the wheel is Maya Craft, and as you can see, I am putting it on a non-gliding thing. It's the thing that you put under the rugs on the floor. And I was so irritated because the wheel was just moving away from me. So I have it on this non-gliding thing. And yes, Maya Craft, I think it's the Pioneer. And I told you about this wheel in another podcast, that I have had it lent out to a friend, and I just got it back last year. And yesterday I was giving it some oil and some, yes, I found this anti-gliding thing to put under it, and it was so perfect. So now I'm so happy to sit here and spin the rest of my Gotland. Thank you. hope that you enjoyed watching me spin and also talk a little bit about what I was doing while you were watching. And I have now ended up with 1,500 meters of lovely single Gotland wool. And it makes me really, really happy to take care of the fibers from beginning to the end like this. And as I have said before, this is a little bit of a testing for me because I haven't done singles before. I have always done 2-ply and plied it on itself. And yes, this is exciting. I'm now hoping to have enough here, or I know I have enough. I have 1,500 meters. That can absolutely be a sweater for me. So beautiful, beautiful Gotland wool has now turned into beautiful singles. And yes, I do hope that when they are dry here, that I can take them through the wheel again to ease up the last bit of twist that are in this yarn. But it's not too bad. When I took them off the Niddy Noddy, they were curled up really, really badly. And now they are just a little bit wavy. But they are not, the skein is not twisting itself. So yeah, a little bit I have left, but not too bad. So, yes, now you have followed me from the start to the end, and I really hope that you enjoyed this process. After this, when I stop talking to you today, I have added some more spinning. For those of you who like to watch other people spin, I do. I love to see how other people spin, since I'm not the learned spinning in a professional way. I just spin the way I feel like I want to spin. So it's always interesting, I think, to watch other people spin. So there will be a clip here at the end when I'm spinning this fiber, so you can see. And if you want to support my work with this channel, there is a link under this video to ko-fi.com. And there is also the possibility to become a patron. And I will also link to my Patreon site. And you can choose from, I think I have 4 different levels there. So if you want to support me monthly, that's a possibility. Thank you so much for watching, and I really hope that you enjoyed this.